Assalamu alaikum, dear students. This is me, Ms. Madia Rahman, the teacher of the Smart School Sir Syed Ahmed Khan campuses and Gulistan Johar campus. I welcome you all to your grade 5 science lecture. We are continuing the chapter microorganisms and we are going to solve the question and answers in this video. Let us begin in the name of Allah. Rabbi Zidni Ilma, Rabbi Zidni Ilma. रब्बी जिदनी इल्मा, ऐ मेरे रब मेरे इल्म में इजाफा फरमा. व्हाट आर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स? आंसर, इट इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ लिविंग थिंग्स. माइक्रो मींस स्मॉल एंड ऑर्गेनिजम्स मींस लिविंग थिंग्स. माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑल्सो नोन एज माइक्रोब्स आर एक्सट्रीमली स्मॉल एंड कैन नॉट बी सीन विदाउट अ माइक्रोस्कोप. You will write the question with the black pen and answer with the blue pen. You will write the topic, question and answers on the heading line and date on the left hand corner, classwork on the right hand corner. Question number 2. Name 3 microorganisms. The 3 microorganisms are bacteria, fungi, viruses. Question number 3. What are viruses? The word virus means poison. The word virus means poison. Viruses are even smaller than bacterium. They are on the borderline of living and non-living things. Meaning viruses are, we neither conclude them as living, neither non-living things, and they are at the border of both the groups. And the word virus means poison. Why are viruses considered non-living things? Viruses are not made out of cells. They can't keep themselves in a stable state. They don't grow and they can't make their own energy. That is why they are considered as non-living things. Because growing, changing their stability, making their own energy, these are the qualities of living things, and the virus does not have these qualities, so we consider them as non-living things as well. Question number 5. How do bacteria and fungi help in decomposition? Fungi and bacteria are the major organisms decomposing dead leaves and other organic matter. Organic matter is broken down into carbon dioxide and the mineral forms of nutrients like nitrogen. It is also converted into fungi and bacteria through these organisms feeding on the organic material and reproducing. So this is the method of decomposition that bacteria and fungi helps in. You can pause the video and continue writing this in your science copy. Question number 6. Write the name of any 2 diseases caused by the following microorganism. Bacteria. Bacteria causes pneumonia and tuberculosis. Fungi. It causes athlete's foot and ringworm. Virus causes influenza and chicken pox. So these are the diseases that are caused by these microorganisms. Question number 7. Outline 5 uses of microorganisms in our daily life. Now we have to tell that how we can use microorganisms in our daily life. The uses of microorganisms in our daily life is, number 1, fungi are used to make antibiotics. Many medicines are made from the microorganisms, so antibiotics are made from fungi. Many drugs such as insulin is synthesized from bacteria. Bacteria play an important role in decomposing organic matter. Many foods such as yogurt, cheese and vinegar are prepared by using different types of bacteria. Fungi break down the dead bodies into simpler substances. So these are some of the common uses of microorganisms in our daily life. they are harmful and useful both for ourselves and our body. So we can use them to make so many things, and they can also harm us in different ways, such as diseases. I hope that solving these question answers, you have cleared the concept of the chapter. If you are confused with any topic, you should reread the topic and understand it, so that you can prepare yourself well for your next exam, or it is good to have a better understanding of all the chapters pre-hand. I hope that you have enjoyed this video and you will complete your classwork in your copies. Till the next video, this is me, Ms. Madhya Rehman, signing off. Allah Hafiz.